Hello everyone, and thank you for joining again this course. So today we will be starting the chapter number 2, which is digital seismic pre-processing. So in this we have two modules, which is the first module is data conditioning and formatting. So and the second module which consists of filters and gain. So in first module we have more sub videos. So the first video which we are going to share is the seismic data recording system. So to get to know how the seismic data recording system work. So in end of this video you will be able to know about the geophone and its internal function, how does it work, and also you will be able to understand the seismic recording system in the detail. So let's start with the geophone, which is normally used for land case and for the small scale survey. So actually the seismic data recording system, which is a geophone, picks the seismic signal or the vibration from the geophone sensor and record them in the magnetic media in a digital format. So it consists of multiple channels, each connected to a geophone group, which is called the cable. So if you have like 24 geophones, so it will be connected with one cable. Or if you, in some cases, we have hundreds of geophones in a large survey. And it is similar to an audio tape recorder, which picks the audio signals from the microphone and record them on the magnetic tapes, which is normally we are listening on the CD or in the magnetic tapes. So how does it work? So actually a geophone is a transducer which transform mechanical energy, seismic vibrations, into the electrical energy. And it consists of moving coil, which is our here. So which this is the moving coil on the right side. And the movement of the coil due to the vibration create the electromagnetic flux proportional to the magnitude of vibration. So here is a geophone which is in actual, it looks like. So if we see the internal function, so this part actually goes into the ground and we have this magnet over here, which is north and south poles, a pole are here. And this is actually the coil, and once the vibrations comes and feels from this body, that it's convert from the mechanical energy into the magnetic flux, electromagnetic flux. So then this can be recorded and it's connected to the channels and it record at the surface or the recording system. So let's see the detail of the seismic data recording system. So this is actually the diagram which is taken from Khalid Amin Khan 2010. So we start with the geophone. So the geophone is over here. Then once it records the signal, it looks like this one. So then we have the pre-amplifier. So it amplifies the amplitude of this signal, which is the given signal. So then we have different filters, which is low cut notch filter and high cut filter. So the low cut filters actually remove the noises, which is below 10 hertz, and 50 to 60 is normally used for power induction lines, which is 50 to 60 hertz. And 125 is a higher frequency, so which is not actually needed for our data. So then once it's passed through this all filter, so you can see the small spikes which was here, it's already removed and you have the refined signal. So again, this amplification is not enough. Then we again have another amplifier which amplify the amplitude of these signals. Then it comes to the multiplexer. And the multiplexer, after multiplexer, if you have number of geophone, then it converts all geophone energy from this multiplexer in a sampling rate time, and then it comes to the analog to digital converter. Then again it's come to the formatters. Then either you need the segy, segy or sgy, so whatever you need the format, it can convert the format here, then write on the magnetic tape, cartridge or DVD. So we go into the detail of each and every one. So preamplifier actually receives the weak signals from the geophone and amplifies them. So these are the filters which we already discussed. So actually the low cut filter attenuate the frequency below the cutoff frequency and pass all the frequency which is above that. So if let's say if we are talking about low cut, so it means it will cut from here onward. So this frequency will be cut and this frequency will be absorbing the data. So notch filter is actually, this is a special filter when we are doing the land acquisition and you have the power induction line, electric power lines. So then normally the frequency of that power induction lines are also absorbed in our data set. So we have to remove this type of frequency from the data set. So the high cut filter is normally, which is very high frequency, which is not needed actually for the seismic data. So that's why we remove this type of frequency, which actually cause the aliasing effect. Then we have the amplifier. Amplifier is again, actually it converts from the signal, which is input, and it enhance the amplitude of the signal. So it's called the amplifier from the filter. So the multiplexer, I'm going to discuss in the second video, which is in detail. So this one will skip here. So now we come to the analog to digital converter, which is over here. So that's actually convert your signals. It's recording in analog form and it convert into digital. Then it's formatter and writers. Okay, thank you so much. And I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have understand the recording system of the seismic data. Thank you so much.